Good morning, everyone. I'm gonna try and be quiet here because all my neighbors are still asleep. Just out here walking calm before my morning run. It's Friday, it's the last day of March. Tomorrow is the craft beer half marathon in Charlotte. I'm about to do my shakeout run here. It's been beautiful running weather all week, but naturally that means it's gonna be crappy running weather for race day tomorrow. Looking ahead at the weather, it's going to be 64, 65 at the start, which is a great day to hang around, but not a good day to run in, especially if you're going to try and run hard and run fast. Also, the rain possibility has gone down a little bit, but we're still likely going to have a lot of rain. And then the big factor, for me at least, is the wind. There's going to be sustained, winds in the 20s with gusts in the high 30s approaching 40, and that's that just kind of takes it out of you. So of course on Sunday after the race the weather is going to be great running weather again, so it's really only race day where the weather is going to be crappy, and that's going to kind of affect my gear choice, which I'll talk about, if not in this video, then, you know, tomorrow when before I actually go to the race. But right now it's about 50 degrees and it's great weather for a shakeout. So I'm gonna go for about a 30 minute shakeout, not with Khan, because he can't run for 30 minutes. And then we'll talk to you about the course. So here's the big choice I have to make for race day. Some of this gear is gonna be pretty standard for me, like the Reckless Running singlet. I love the Skull Crusher design. The Injinji lightweight socks, of course, as always. And I'm gonna want split shorts with as little coverage as possible for that kind of temperature and freedom of movement. I'll take at least a couple of goos, probably one beforehand, at least one during the race. I know a lot of people don't goo up in a half marathon, but I do. I'm gonna save the Martins for more of a focus race or a marathon. But the shoes are gonna be the big dilemma. The Hokas I've been wanting to put in a race setting, the Rocket X2, but even though I've already muddied them up on their first run, I don't know if I wanna race in them. Yeah, I know, buddy. I don't know if I want to muddy them up because I really like them a lot, and I might want to save them and not get them all mucked up again because they might be something I use in a more of a focus race later. I know these work in the bad weather because they worked fine in that 10 miler I did on unpaved surfaces just last week, the Saucony Endorphin Pro 3. And they're a little bit beat up already. You know, if I get in a little bit close there, that's where I normally wear out most of my shoes in the first place. And a lot of that outsole has kind of been worn down, but they still ride the same. So already got plenty of dents in that car. And there's the Adidas Adios Pro 3. And I've done a few workouts in this one, but not done any races in it. It's really durable. I kind of like the energy return, even though it's not a not a PBAX foam like these other two. It's more of a TPE foam with these energy rods here, but the energy return is just as good. And these pink accents kind of set off those skulls in the Skull Crusher singlet, and I'm not usually a matchy-matchy person, but that does appeal to me, so I'm not gonna lie. So, probably gonna save this guy, and it's gonna be between these two. As far as which one it is, I might just pack them both, and that'll be a game-time decision. Oh!
So you can see why I don't do a lot of filming during the work week on the run, because there's just not a lot of light out at 5 a.m. So I wanted to talk about the course. It's gonna be kind of a lollipop, starting on the roads, uphill trend, and then a downhill to the Greenway. Most of it's gonna be on the McMullen Greenway in Charlotte. Pretty smooth, mostly paved. There's one unpaved section between miles 8 and 10, and that's an out and back. That section is actually going to be kind of south-southwest, which outbound is going to be into that big headwind. So mile 8 to 9, going from a paved to an unpaved surface, and then going into the wind, might be a place where I really need to monitor my energy. And then pretty flat for most of it until the last mile, which is up David Kaler, which is a pretty notorious climb in that area.
So I'm gonna interrupt the run footage here just because the split screen kind of cuts off that last climb there. You can't see it on the split screen, but yeah, that's David Kaler, which I was just talking about. Doesn't look like much here, but it's a lot at the end of the race.
So no course around here is flat and fast. Any course that says so in the Charlotte area, all the way up through Mooresville, etc., is lying. They're just trying to sell entries. Anyway, running out of light here, but we'll see how it goes. Could be a fast race, but not necessarily the optimal conditions for it. All right, where is their street lamp here? So that's kind of my course preview. We'll see how it shapes up on race day. So the shakeout run that I'm doing, sorry, let me get, is 30 minutes, generally easy, maybe with some strides in the back end, 6 to 8 strides, which on a road would look like 15 seconds on, 45 seconds easy. Or sometimes I'll actually count my steps, like 25 steps is about 12 or 13 seconds. And then 70 or 75 jogging steps is about 45 seconds recovery. And those strides are as fast as I can go while still maintaining a smooth and relaxed posture. Full recovery. It's not a workout. It's just a neuromuscular connection. The 30 minutes usually ends up being about 4 miles. Of course, if I'm wearing a really energetic shoe, like today, like the Primex Strung, I might end up doing more than 4 miles in less than 30 minutes by accident. Not that I recommend that, but there is a lot of energy saving in these shoes, and there's something to be said for feeling fast the day before a race. So that's what I got. Next time I talk to you will be race morning.